Good morning, church.
Morning.
I was waiting until, is that 11 o'clock? I need to change my watch. My watch is dying. I'm serious. It says 10:55. I thought I have 5 more minutes. And this is supposed to be a smart watch. It's not like a thing that you can dial to adjust the watch or anything, you know? But my phone say, oh man, I need to complain to Apple. Well, good morning, church. Well, welcome to Memorial United Methodist Church, the greatest church in the world. Well, Happy New Year, everybody. Everybody is doing good? Yeah? I'm so really happy to see you all here today. Also, welcome friends who worship with us online, wherever you are. Happy New Year. How many of you are ready for countdown tonight? Yeah? That's great. You got any plan, great plan for countdown tonight? Let's hear it. Let's hear from everybody. A friend who are worshiping with us online, if you have any plan, write it down on the comment box saying, what do you plan for tonight, countdown? Anybody? That's good. That's a good one. 9 o'clock, you go to sleep. You don't have to count for another year. That's good. Anybody else? Our Hmong group is sponsoring a program tonight from 7 o'clock till midnight. If anybody would like to come, you are welcome to bring a little something to share. There will be food, and so it will be great. 7:30 should be a good time for you to come, and then we'll eat together. We have some fun game and stuff like that together. It's not an organized event. It's going to be a lot of fun, so come as you are, all right? Anybody else? Do you have any plan for tonight countdown service? Anything else? Any big thing waiting for you for New Year 2024? Are you ready for New Year? Oh, it seems like everybody is excited, huh? All right, are you ready for New Year? All right, friends, I just want to welcome you to a time of worship today. Today, we start our worship service at 11 o'clock because every fifth Sunday of the month, we have a combined worship with our Hmong language ministry. And so 11 o'clock is a good time for us to come together. The next one will be in March, and that would be March 31st. And I think it will be on Easter Sunday as well. So it's going to be good. I'm so really happy that you are here today. The service is made just for you. We have in Hmong language. We have in English language. And so I hope that you will enjoy the service today, that the Spirit of God will speak to you today. Friends, let me remind you that we are here to worship our Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever we do today, we want to pay our whole attention to Him. I pray that today, as you worship God, as you praise Him, as you pray to Him, as you are trying to hear from Him, God will speak to you. How many of you are ready to be touched today? Yeah? Are you going to be inspired today? Are you going to leave this place more energetic and go change this world one person at a time? Are you ready to worship?
Yeah.
That sounds very good. I would like to invite Jordan and Jonathan to come down with the light of Christ. The candle represents the Spirit of God with us today. So let's be ready. Let's open our hearts. Let's be reverent. Let's pay attention. God has something big in store for you today. Today is going to be a great day to end our new year, to end our year 2023, and waiting for the great thing that God has in store for us 2024. I would like to invite Andy to come up and help us in time of worship. Andy?
Hello. Hey, for those who like that I do the liturgy, I promise. I mean, I'm sorry to say, this will be the last time I'll do this year, so. If you don't like me doing it, I promise this is the last time I'll do it this year. All right, we got the call to worship up on the screen as well as in your bulletin. I'll read the leadership part. You read the people part in bold out loud. Praise the Lord from the highest heaven. Praise the Lord from the deepest valley. Praise the Lord from the heart of the faithful.
And that the old and young, the wise and the meek, all lift their voices and sing
Worship the Lord our God, ruler of heaven and earth. Please stand as you are able for our opening hymn, the old chestnut, O Come All Ye Faithful. Please remain standing as you are able for the Lord's Prayer. Please say it out loud with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. And our scripture today is from Matthew chapter 2, verses 13 to 23. Now after they had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up and take the child and his mother and flee to Egypt. And remain there until I tell you, for Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night, and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." When Herod saw that he had been tricked by the Magi, he was infuriated, And he sent and killed all the children in and around Bethlehem who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he had learned from the Magi. Then what had been spoken through the prophet Jeremiah was fulfilled. A voice was heard in Ramah, wailing and loud lamentations, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they are no more. When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were seeking the child's life are dead. Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was ruling Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And after being warned in a dream, he went away to the district of Galilee. There he made his home in a town called Nazareth. So that what had been spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene.
Standing on the promises that cannot fail, when the howling storms of doubt veer assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God.
I would like to invite children to come up. And at this moment, why don't we just go around and before we sit down, go ahead and say hi to one another, shake hands, you know, happy Merry Christmas or Happy New Year to one another. Michelle, would you please come up for a time of children's moment? All right, I invite everybody to come sit down, go back to your seat. Happy New Year, everyone. Let's hear from everybody. I want to hear some enthusiasm. Are you looking forward to 2024? It's going to be a good year, don't you think? Yeah, yeah. Kids, would you please come scoot in a little bit? Come scoot in a little bit to the middle. How is everybody doing? How was your Christmas? Everybody got your wanted gift? Yeah? What did you do at church for Christmas? You guys has a lot of things going on during Christmas, correct? At our church? You know, when we look at our church calendar on Christmas, we do a lot of things, huh? We even call ourselves Christmas at Memorial because there were so many activities going on, right? We even put on a big Christmas show. Do you know what that show is called? That was on Saturday and Sunday, remember? The 16th and the 17th. We had a lot of pizza and hot dogs. Right? Yeah, that was a big activity, right? We invite our neighbors to come in and watch a play. What do you call that play? Is it live nativity? Does it sound right? Live nativity? Yeah. What was the best part of the live nativity? What was the best part of live nativity? Michelle, what role did you play in that show? What were you? You were sitting right here. Were you an angel? Were you a shepherd? You was an angel, right? Yeah. How about Allison? What were you? You were also an angel? Where were you? Were you outside in the third station? Yeah. How about you, Ariel? You were a shepherd. Oh, nice. You look like a good shepherd. Were you having fun? How many sheep did you have? Only one, yeah? How about Evelyn? What role did you play?
I was
You were Mary. Oh, you were right here, huh? I think you were with Michael, right? Michael was Joseph, right? With baby. Who was the baby? Oh, it was a mannequin, right? A little baby, a baby doll, right? Oh, okay. I remember. It was great. So what was it all about? What were we trying to tell the neighbors or the visitor? What was the story about? About Jesus. What happened to Jesus? He was born, right, on December 25th. We as Christians chose December 25th as his birthday, right? And so on around that day, we tried to do everything possible to tell the story of the birthday of Jesus. Who can tell me the whole story of that of Jesus' birth? What happened first? Evelyn, what happened first? Tell me your part. What is your part? Mary, what happened to Mary? She gave birth to Jesus, right? Remember she encountered the angel? What did the angel say to her? The angel was coming down to her and tell her that she was going to have a baby, right? Yeah? What happened to the shepherd? What did the shepherd do? Yeah, the shepherd show up. I mean, the angels show up to the shepherd and told the shepherd that, hey, the newborn king is born in Bethlehem. You guys should go and visit, right? Yeah, and you were also the shepherd, correct, Michelle? The angel, right? Were you the angel trying to tell? Who did you visit? Were you in here? Yeah, so you were visiting Mary and Joseph. Right? That's very good. So that is the story of baby Jesus. And then baby Jesus became what? He is God, correct? And we follow him, correct? Why do you think we as Christians follow Jesus? What have you learned from baby Jesus or from Jesus? What is so special about Jesus? I think I asked too many questions, huh? I should be telling the story, right? Not asking too many questions. I think I put you guys on the spot. But hey, so we Christians, we celebrate Jesus. Jesus was born and he grew up and he taught us how to live. And he eventually died on the cross to save us from our sin. And we as Christians, we follow his teaching. We live the life according to his teaching. And we pray that he continue to be with us, right? Help us to continue to grow, to live better life, to live like Jesus' disciples each and every day, right? So I pray that you continue to anchor yourself into God's teaching, into Jesus' teaching, so that you continue to be good and faithful disciples, followers of Jesus. Amen? Let us pray, okay? Let us pray. Lord Jesus, I'm praying for these wonderful children, Evelyn, Ariel, Allison, and Michelle, and many other children who are not here today. I pray that your love and your teaching to be with them as always, Lord. Continue to protect them as they continue to grow in this wonderful world. Give them the best life that they dream of. Help them to become the people that you want them to be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for coming, friend. Let's give them a big round of applause. They were so much help for our wonderful program. You may go back to your seat. Thank you. Thank you. Everybody is doing good? Friends, whether you like it or not, this is a wonderful church. No argument about it. No discussion about it. Nobody can say no to it, right? And when you come to this church, please remember, I love you. Jesus loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it, hey? Amen? Hey, how about this? You say it to one another. I want you, the friends who are sitting on my left, you know, these few, looking to friends who are sitting on my right. No, I mean, those who are sitting on my right, look at those who are sitting on my left. Look at them in the eyes, you know. There are a lot of them, right? Big army of Christians over there. Tell them loud and proud that I love you. Jesus loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Are you ready? Clear your throat. All right, ready? 1, 2, 3. I love Jesus loves you, and nothing. Wow, good job. Give yourself a big round of applause. You guys are good. And friends out there, you can do better, right? Prove to me that you can do better, all right? I mean, if you cannot do better, there's something wrong with you, okay? We need to do it. Clear your throat. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Amen. Let's give God a big round of applause, huh? Wow. Happy New Year, friends. Let us go to God in time of prayer. Do we have any special prayer requests or prayer of thanksgiving? I have cards right here. If you have any prayer you need to write down, you want to let me know, please do that. Let me start by telling you that Barbara Woodward, she's doing very good. She's healing well. She had a car accident a few weeks back. I visited her. She's still wearing the neck brace, but she's recovering. And in fact, right now she's living with her son's girlfriend while her house is being renovated. So she will be moving into a better renovated home, you know, so that's a good part of it too. So, you know, if you want to give her a call, you can give her a call. I visited her, I called her too, and so that's very good. Praying for Jeanette. As she is recovering from the broken shoulder, Janet. And also praying for Clara, whose cancer has returned and has metastasized, is spreading. So we pray that God healing be with Clara, and also give him her the strength that she needs as well. Anybody else? Do we have any other prayer, Thanksgiving prayer requests that we can think of? We praise God for another year. Amen to that? Yeah, we are looking forward to 2024. I know that God has big things in store for you. It's going to be great. So be ready for it. Be on your best behavior. Be on your best physical condition. Be on your best mental condition. God's going to work in you. God's going to change this world one person at a time, starting from you, going out, being the agent of love, being the agent of light, to go and make this world a brighter place, a happier place. Please join with me in a time of prayer. I invite you all to sit comfortably wherever you are right now. Breathe deeply and slowly. Close your eyes. Speak to God if you want to. God is listening right now. With your prayer of thanksgiving, prayer of petition, or just listen. Maybe God has something to say to you. I'm going to give you a minute of silent, a time of silent prayer. Loving and merciful God, we come here in this place to worship you. Lord, may our act of worship be acceptable to you. Lord, I pray that as we continue to give ourselves to you, to grow closer to you, to build relationship with you, I pray that your love continue to shine in us, through us, that your power continue to encourage us, to give us the strength that we need, Lord, especially to handle the thing that is going to face us in the near future, and especially for the next year to come. Lord, we remember our friends and our loved ones. We remember those who are going through medical procedure. May your healing power be with them, Lord. We give you thanks for those who are recovering from the illness or from the injury. We're praying for those who are having a difficult time right now. Maybe it is financial situation or family relationship or job or stress related. Lord, may your comfort be with them. Lord, we pray that you are Emmanuel, that you are always with each and every one of us. May your presence be tangible to each and every one of us. So we can always realize that somebody is always walking alongside with us. Lord, we're praying for Jews' daughters as well. whatever they are going through, may your power be with them. Especially for Connie, as she's looking for a better job. Not Connie or Pharaoh, another Connie. But Lord, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And at this moment, may the word of my mouth and the meditation of our heart be acceptable to you, because you are our rock and you are our redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. While I was praying, there's a prayer card by Jew asking to pray for Connie and for a better job. And I thought, that's not Connie or Pharaoh. I don't think she needs a better job than that. That's what she has right now, right? Well, that's good. Friends, let me start with a funny story. How about that? Okay? That's a little story. One boy at school, he was walking too close with this little girl all the time. And then, you know, it become a little disturbing. And his other friends say, why do you always walk next to her? And the boy said, because last Sunday, my Sunday school teacher told me to always walk by faith. That is why he's always walking next to Faith. Oh, Sunday school teacher, you better tell a good story. All right, friends, so I would like to invite Mary. Mary, would you please come up and help me? You know, maybe we can unfold the story together, you know, into two different languages. I hope that our Hmong brother and sister, especially the first generation, whose English is the second language, I mean, a lot of us, English is a second language, will be able to understand this story. I think it's a very interesting story.
I'll do my best, because on the way to church this morning, I told Jack, I'm so thankful that Pastor don't ask me to translate this time. And then when I got here, he said, you will be translator. I'm like, oh, okay.
You never know, you know, the angels always tell you the last minute, right? It's not like you have a lot of time to prepare for it. So this is a story of very interesting. Okay, so when I was looking at this story, look, friends, we were having great time preparing for Christmas, right? Christmas is always good about, you know, the good news of Jesus, gift, party, celebration, prime rib, dungeon crab, and all that, right?
So Christmas,
you know, family together, celebration, all good stuff. And then December 25th is gone. How many of you already put away your Christmas decoration? Already? Can you wait until like January
6th?
Right, the tradition is like you're supposed to wait until January 6th, right? The King's Day, right? But you know, I don't blame some of you who already put away some Christmas ornaments and decoration. We went all in, you know, all out for Christmas, and all of a sudden the Christmas spirit is just like,
ooh.
And right after Christmas story, here you go, there's a story of Jesus having to flee from his country to Egypt. Everything was so good, and all of a sudden it just like dropped 90 degrees down, and everything is to the dark glory, you know? Verse 13, it says, now after they had left, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, get up, take the child and his mother, if you go to the picture, you will see, it's very interesting how, you know, they were comfortable, they were cozy, they were having good time there in Bethlehem, and all of a sudden they, the Magi, came to them, visit them, bring them gift, you know, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and now the Magi left, And the angel came to Joseph and said, you better get up, packed up, and go right now. Do you remember when you were having small children? Going everywhere packing is not easy. You gotta have diaper, you gotta get formula, you gotta have medicine, you gotta get everything ready because your child is specific for that little thing. And that is why in our generation, vans are created because of that reason, right? And for our Hmong family, we are trying to even outgrow that van. Joseph and Mary, they had to flee from their country, Bethlehem, in Israel. They had to go all the way to Egypt and to remain there for an unknown time. Very interesting, right? Egypt again. Why Egypt? Remember, the Israelites, they had to flee from Egypt out of slavery. Remember during Moses' time. Moses delivered his people from Egypt to come to the promised land. Now Jesus, in order to be saved, he has to be in Egypt. The question is, why Egypt? It will be difficult for them. They will have to speak different language. They will have to change, adapt to a different culture. And the road might not be even safe for them. But there is no choice. They got to go. Because now they have to face that command from Caesar, from Herod the Great. Herod the Great was not happy when the Magi came to him and said, hey, a newborn king was just born. I'm going to visit the newborn king now. And Herod the Great, look at this guy. This guy was, he was called the Great because he was so mean. This guy, when he was in power, he was trying to prove to the world that he is the Great. The first picture, his face was put into the currency, into the coin. That is, everybody has to know who he is. The second picture is called the Herodium. It's where he lived. He built his own castle up on top of the hill. He has the money, he has the people, he has the power, he has the time to make it happen for him to be the great. And the next picture is about the worship place. It's where everybody was going there to worship, and it's going to be great temple. And so Herod was doing everything possible to show the world that he is so good. And nothing, literally nothing, can stop him from being great. He even had to first banish his first wife and his son so that they are not in his way. This guy met it 10 times because if he does not like it, he get new ones. The story goes like he even killed one of his wife and three of his sons because of his paranoia. You know, he has to be the great. Nobody can be in his way. Not even his wife, not even his sons. So the story of a newborn king, no way, I'm going to go get that newborn king. So his command was to kill anybody, any kids, the year of newborn to 2-year-old. Can you imagine? So when a decree comes from this guy to go kill all these kids, what does Joseph and Mary have? They have to flee.
So
the next picture here talking about show the trip that Mary and Joseph has to do.
So that
you look in the top north, you will see Nazareth. That's where Mary and Joseph were living over there.
So you may shy to call the each upon your shah shah and your John Nasaleg, my lawyer said to your shah.
And when they had to do the census, they have to move down to Bethlehem to do the census.
So talk to your shah shah and your shah shah and your Bethlehem.
And that is where you heard the story of the birth of Jesus happened in Bethlehem, right? So he was Joseph and Mary and baby Jesus was living and growing up in Bethlehem for a while, for probably a couple years. Now they have to move, if you see the number 4, down from Bethlehem to Egypt. And after a while, the angel appeared to Joseph again, saying, now Herod the Great is done, he's dead, it's time for you to move back. And where are you going to? You're going to Nazareth. And the word Nazareth is from Hebrew word that is netzer, meaning shoot. If you notice, sometimes there's a big tree that got chopped down, but then the shoot will grow back from that tree. And that is based on the Isaiah prophecy from the book of Isaiah chapter 11 verse 1 that say, there shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch from his shoot shall bear fruit. Now, Jesus and Elizabeth and Jesus, Mary and Joseph move from Egypt back to Nazareth in order to fulfill this prophecy from Isaiah. Recently, they even found this little house that they believe is probably the house that Jesus was spending his childhood in. It's the rock cut doorway of a first century house discovered near Sister of Nazareth Convent, which may have been the childhood home of Jesus, and photo credit to Ken Dog. I don't know about you, but when I saw that picture, somehow I picture little Jesus running around there. You know, he's trying to tell his father what to do, what not to do, especially when his father was working on the woodwork. You know, he's trying to outsmart his father all the time, you know. And telling his father, like, no, you don't know anything. I know better, you know. you know what I'm talking about, right? When this kid is running around in this place trying to live this little humble life.
And
then when we think about Nazareth, what is Nazareth? It's just a little town of 40, 50 families.
So you must Nazareth,
it's a very modest town. There is nothing great coming out of that town. Remember when Jesus grew up and people start to know about Jesus and the disciples go out and talk to Nathaniel and saying that, hey, look, there's a great teacher, Jesus of Nazareth. And then Nathaniel said, Nazareth? Can anything good come from there? And Philip, the disciples of Jesus, had nothing to prove but say, come and see. When Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, he said to him, here truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit. The Israelite in whom there is no deceit. Think about how great Jesus is. Grew up in this little town that nothing is significant about that town. But then Jesus continued to grow, continued to touch people, continued to teach people, and his teaching continued to touch all of us. An author, Lyle Rawling III, in 2008, she wrote about the greatest man in history, and that is Jesus. I want us all to really think about Jesus of Nazareth. I think her writing is pretty spot on. It's very interesting. Jesus had no servant, yet they call him master. He had no degree, yet they call him teacher. He had no medicines, yet they call him healer. He had no army, yet kings fear him. He won no military battle, yet he conquered the world. He did not live in a castle, yet they call him Lord. He ruled no nations, yet they call him king. He committed no crime, yet they crucified him. And he was buried in a tomb, yet he lived today. And that's what I want you all to really focus on, friends. That Jesus lives today. Jesus lives in all of us. You know, the history of Christianity is going up and down, going through some happy time, going through some dark time, right? Back in 1940s to 1960s, Christianity, especially in our country, was booming, was growing so well. It looked like right after the Second World War, all these soldiers, armies, they come back to our country. They were celebrating, they were getting married, and they were making babies, and we call them the baby boomers. How many of you are the baby boomers? Right? Yeah.
And
And then the parents, your parents will go to church and your parents make you go to church, right? And church will growing bigger and bigger, right? Church will grow so big that they were moving from one place to another, making bigger sanctuary, making bigger Sunday school program. Think about our church, right? 1963, when this sanctuary was finished. It's like in the pinnacle, the top time when our church was just growing so well, there was not even enough pews to receive people. Everything was going so well, and all of a sudden, stores, malls, entertainment places started to open back up on Sundays. How many of you remember when Sunday nothing was open but church?
If
you are young, don't raise your hand because you don't know that. Because now Sundays you have a lot of other options to go to, right? A lot of other places to do. And then people started to leave church left and right. And at this moment, you know about it, that, you know, the number of people going to church declined so much. Like, this is the lowest time in the history of our country. Back in the 1950s, it was told that almost half of the people, half of our country, every Sunday they go to church. Half of the people go to church. A few years back, there was a study. How many people go to church? The question is, did you go to church last Sunday? And 17% of the whole population say yes, they did. Only 17%, friends. And where will it be? What will happen in the next 25 years? If you use England as a measurement, as a future prediction, they think England is about 25 years ahead of America in terms of sexuality. Right now in England, 3% of the people go to church every Sunday. Is the next 25 years in our country? Can you imagine? That's before I get retired, before I'm retired. And only 3% of the people go to church. And don't you think England has tried everything possible in order to attract people to come to church? You know, the mega church strategy, you know, trying to bring all kinds of pop concert, everything, you know, control the light, the sanctuary, become contemporary and everything like that. Don't you think they have tried that? Because that's what we are doing right now in our country, right? The church that are thriving, that are growing, are those mega churches that are able to have all these resources to put together shows so that it attracts thousands of people to come to church every Sunday. You know, as your preacher, I'm standing here every time when I start looking and see, oh, new visitor, are they coming back again next week? why or why not? What am I going to do? You know, how am I going to attract them to come back?
So oi to don he ku je wan chi su lu ku nyo jo ti no na ya te ten dao ja ku pu jo don he cha la chi jo don he ku den te po chi to la na ya ku da o bu yo wan chu chong po lu sha la chi bu yo po sa ja ka to pe ha wan chu lo no o ju ku sang la ho.
Let me be honest, I'm not the greatest preacher in the world.
Right,
we don't have the best pop band or rock band in the country. You know, I like Nancy, I like Jenny, I like Darren, I like Craig, you know. Yeah, the song that we provide is very good, right? Well, we don't have the best snack in the world. You know, I like what Sharon is offering, you know, but we don't have Starbucks all the time.
But so
how can we, as a little small church like this, keep attracting new visitors and allow them to come back for the third time and then join our church in the near future? You know, I'm just trying to tie in with the story of Christmas. Everything was booming and great, and all of a sudden, Jesus has to go back all the way to Egypt. And then he had to come back all the way to Nazareth, a lowly place. But then the end of the story is Jesus still lives in all of us. Friends, I don't know what the future holds for our Christian churches, but I pray that God continue to live with each and every one of you. That his teaching continue to root in your heart. That you continue to build friendship with one another like no others. That each of you continue to be proud of your Christian faith and your Christian fellowship. That because God has been residing in your life is so much better and you want others to experience that
too.
And friends, let us end this year, 2023, with a time of Holy Communion. This is when we remember Christ's forgiveness, sacrificial love on the cross for all of us.
'23
is almost behind us in just a few hours. Yes, we have had a lot of good times together for the last 364
days.
And yes, we probably step on each other's toe for some unknown, unintentional things that we do to one another. And we will follow the example of Jesus to forgive one another. To continue to build our fellowship, Christian fellowship, each and every day. And to be ready to receive the blessing for 2024. God is good, amen. And all the time. And so, friends, let's come together to the Lord's table. Before the dinner started, Jesus took the bread. And he broke it and he gave thanks to God and he gave it to the disciples. And said, take and eat, this is my body broken for you. The body of Christ was broken on the cross so that we all are healed. I pray that whatever broken in the year 2023 is all gone and is now going to be healed up in
2024.
After the dinner, Jesus took the cup. Give thanks to God and give it to disciples. And he said, this is the cup of the new covenant poured out for you and for many. Drink from this cup for the forgiveness of your sins. As we come down and receive the blood of Christ, I pray that we will forgive each other like Christ has forgiven us. I invite us all to come. In our church, everybody is invited to the Lord's table. You don't have to be a member of this church. I pray that when you come down to receive the body of Christ and the blood of Christ, God will work in you. I invite Sifu Lichai to come up and assist me and Celerina. And as we are receiving the Holy Communion, Alea is going to sing the song, the communion song for us as well.
Is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. Overflow in this place, fill our hearts with your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love surrounds. Is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. Overflow in this place, fill our hearts with your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to done here as in heaven. miracle can happen now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here.
You know, as I continue to think about what has been happening in our wonderful church since after that pandemic, you know, 2020 was a very hard time for lots and lots of churches, big or small, especially small churches, that will have to endure the shutdown, you know, the social distancing, the fact that nobody was able to come to church, and then almost 2 years later, when our church opened back up, not all the people come back, right? Worse, the last 1.5 years of COVID, we couldn't make any more disciples. You know, our church couldn't attract new members, not that I know of, that, you know, new members join church while we worship on Zoom. You know, it's difficult, right? But then, hey, we come back together back in July 2021, we come back to in-person worship. We come back strong. We do everything possible. We commit our heartburst together. We give our time, our talent, our treasure, so that we can continue to be good and faithful disciples for Christ, so that we can continue to allow others to experience God's love, God's forgiveness. And we are here today, celebrating, worshiping God as we see people continue to come back. We continue to make disciples. We continue to allow others to know the teaching of Jesus. Is our job done? No, we are not done yet. Our call continues to be upon us. We still continue to have the responsibility to carry the mission that God has entrusted in our hands. As we, as a church, we come together and we say, we commit our heartburst to do what? To show and tell God's love so that our community can be uplifted. Exactly what we did last week, a couple weeks back, when we allow hundreds of people to come to our church campus to see the story, the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ, that the Savior is born here in this place. And because God was born, because God is with us all, we have hope and we continue to live this world with strength, with inspiration from Him. Friends, now I invite you to worship God through a time of tithe and offering. I just want to say thank you so much for your support. It's been so easy for me to pastor this church because it's not hard, because I don't have to come and beg you to give because our budget is behind. No, our church is doing okay. We are not having like millions of dollars in our bank account, but at least we're not running in the red, right? We are doing good, and thank you for your support. So you are invited to worship through a time of tithe and offering. The offering plate is right next to the door, so you can drop your offering into the offering plate, or you can give online as well. Aim your camera phone onto that QR code. You will be able to give online. Would you please say with me that Thanksgiving prayer that you can find upon the screen? Do we have one? The Thanksgiving prayer? Let's say it with me. Glorious God, source of all that was and is and that will be, we thank you for your many blessings. You sing the stars into being and stretch out your hand to call forth waters to cover the deep. You plant fruit trees to feed your creatures and cause the sun and moon to provide warmth and light. Your steadfast love provides everything we need to walk in blessedness upon the earth. In thankfulness and praise for your many gifts, we offer you our love, our service, and our offerings. In the name of Christ, who came to be our salvation, all praise and glory be unto you. Amen. Would you please stand for a time of doxology?
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Praise God above all earthlings woes. Praise God, our Son and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you so much, friends, for coming. While you're still standing, would you please receive the benediction? May the Spirit of God be with you wherever you are, especially when you leave this place. Please remember, the light of Christ is going to go out with you. The light of Christ is going to be in your heart. So wherever you are, you will be the light of Christ to shine in the world. The world is brighter because of wherever you are. May year 2024 be filled with God's love, God's grace, and God's forgiveness for all of you. May He reveal the treasure, the plan that He has for you, so that you will be strategized, so you will be energized to go out and fulfill the mission God has given you. God is good, and all the time. Thank you so much, friends, for coming to worship with us. After this, we also have fellowship in the fellowship hall. We've got some snacks and refreshment for you as well. It's time for us to, not the fellowship hall, but in the narthex, so that we can continue to fellowship with one another. Thank you so much, friend. God bless you, and I will see you all next week.